Well, hi, excellent. One more round of applause, everyone. Yay! So some of you here might be thinking, what is going on here? This is a normal kind of networking event. Well, we're not normal, and neither is the Chemistry Works. And that's why we're here tonight, to give a big launch to who they are. Now, this is actually a small plethora of the team that is here. The Chemistry Works is an amazing collaboration of individual companies who've established massive relationships within their own industries. And these guys, they've brought together and they've brought each other work over the years, and now is the time that they're wanting to bring it all together under one roof and give you the best service possible. So, we have on our panel here Simon and Susan, Baz and Jill. And we're going to get a little introduction on each of those first. But Simon is kind of the forefront and the sort of the seed and brainchild of bringing this all together. Everyone's collaboration came in on it, but Simon was kind of the spearhead of it all. And so Simon, how did you decide and work with everybody that is part of Chemistry Works and bring it all together?
Shout!
Is there a microphone? We're everyone in the back to be quiet! There's a show going on! Simon, back to you.
I found myself in meetings all over Warwick where clients were... I could tell they were asking for more than Greenwich Design really offered.
And what does Greenwich Design offer?
Brand, visual identity, and communications. But, you know, we'd be frequently be asked to get involved in the design of a website, or product design, or environmental design, PR, or lots of things that are outside of our company's presence. And I wanted to make sure that we were in a position where...
Can you use the microphone?
Unfortunately not, the lead doesn't go as far as we need it to.
So shut up.
You can go to everyone in the back room to be quiet or come in and pay attention. That'd be wonderful.
We need to speak a lot louder.
We could do that, yes. Right, let's give it a go, because we can improvise, that's fine. Right, I'll tell you what, I'll stand here with the mic, and then we can do musical chairs. We can do that. Okay. CK, can you just check if I'm on camera still?
No.
I'll do a little bit of a readjustment.
Oh, okay.
Okay. I think it's up. Let me just turn it up a little bit. Oh, okay. Well, I can sit down for a while. That's okay. Right. Okay. So you have to have, it's a directional mic. So it can be really.
I should have got caught in my dress.
Right, so you have to be very directional. So, Simon, as you were saying, tell us a bit about Greenwich and how it all then started with Chemistry Works. It's on, you've got to
hold
it for that.
What we found, it was really a directive from our clients, actually. We were finding that we would be in meetings where, over and above what we were doing and what our core skills are, we'd be asked to be involved in projects that would require more. And rather than us just being the people that would be sort of front expertise in other areas, we wanted to get those other areas into the room and sharing the projects directly. And we were kind of doing that anyway, because we subcontract work out to the experts. But all too often you find yourself actually trying to answer questions that you can't answer, because that's not your expertise. So get the people in the room. But get the people in the room under the one banner of one company or another, and confusing clients with lots of different companies in one room. So it seems the logical thing to do.
And so how long will it mean you yourself? How long have you been working with Baz and Susan and Jill, for example?
I've been working with Baz for about 6 years, I think, 6 years. A little less for Jill, but that's the point of the chemistry works. You build up this organic, you put out more people as when you get the experts in. There are some people in the group that I've worked with for 20, 25 years, so it's all about having same views that you have about how creative the work will be. And it just makes sense to get the other one as well.
We'll have a little chat with
Baz,
Susan, and Jill about what it is exactly they do within the umbrella of
Commission. Yeah, I mean, intentionally, everybody in the group do different things. There's no point in having two people doing the same thing, it's not just the two. So we have obviously ourselves, brand and visual identity, we have Baz, we've got photography, PR, brand vision, product design, environmental design, digital design, social media. So we're trying to cover all the bases, but with experts, not a jack of all trades. That's not what we're looking for.
Although you are a jack of all trades, but each person is their expert in their field. And you also do things like product design, and that's in the retail side, and the industrial side. And I have to say this because I just found it very funny, when talking to your product guys, Earlier on, what was that there? Yes. And I said, well, what do you do in terms of product design? And that's work on. And I'm sorry to say, they said, well, it varies from town halls to lawnmowers. So there's obviously quite a big scale of things that they work on. So no product is too outside their remit, I would say. So I'd like to pass over to Baz in a second. Where I am as a Synergy16, we are about connecting people. And it's actually through Hyde that me and Baz first met. And that's why we've come back here tonight to celebrate the launch of Chemistry Works. I met Baz here. He's taken some beautiful photographs when we've done events here and previously. So Baz, like, how did you start with your photography, and what do you look out for in photography, and what do you love about photography?
That's a good question. I suppose it comes down to storytelling. I like to be able to tell stories in my picture rather than set up shots and identifying scenes that grab the energy and then try to explore it. And I think relating to what Simon said, I mean, the whole point of branding is effectively. We're always communicating in some people as well. But I just happen to be visual alongside another couple of colleagues who has got a very different skill to do behind the screen than he does, and it's very different than he does. So that's a photographic point of view. We can put a perspective which doesn't feel as well, because the world of brands now we can move as much more, so we can adjust to that. But instead of wearing the hat of each award, we can bring in very talented people like this kind of record super to do some magical stuff for us and potentially from the brands.
Microsite product design is part of that as well, in terms of offering special things for the event. So it's really been freeing us up and helping us give that
and in terms of, what is your favourite campaign that you've worked on and why?
Apart from helping Oxford Chemistry Works, I guess it probably would be that Waterloo Memorial. Because it was such a fantastic idea. We managed to get the Chase Wellington to come along there. We had Peter Snow from Class from Paul Green, which we expect, to actually kind of help us do something very important, which was to commemorate with the important. So such a big idea. It was ultimately selling things, commemorative items that raised money to charity, so it kind of had a big part as well. So it was a great campaign, and it was kind of something looking at Gary.
And then, so you're on the PR side, but before that, if an aid, like, I'm sure your clients at some point would have had the idea, like, we've got this idea, but how do we deliver it as the brand message, the narrative, which I guess is where you come in, Jill, because you're a brand strategist, and it's the Rhymid method that has been designed by Jill. She's going to give a little background as to what that is, because it's synonymous with yourself. So I will pass it to you.
Any brief that comes in, I tend to get to step back and actually start again and say, actually, let's just regroup and rethink. And I've got a tool called the Chiming, which basically is like a brand demo, but it's got two other sides to it. It's a three-sided pyramid. And it's basically saying to you, think about your brand, not just in isolation, but think about it in context of the marketplace and in context of your own business. So if you're a business multi-brand, then I used to run Personal Washing Up with Bliss, so I was a sister to Personal, but you know, Personal was Unilever, and I was a little baby, and I managed to shout loud because I had lots of money and I was part of my family. So I've got a chime in that helps people to say, right, let's just rethink and reiterate, because often business, that gets forgotten about, it's in manuals, and it just doesn't live anymore. So I can ask very stupid, simple questions, like, what market are you in? You'll go, well, I'm in the wellness market. Are you in wellness or are you in health? Are you in paint? Are you in decorating? So it's very much about helping you interrogate, re-interrogate your brand again. From that, you can then get a better brief from designers. You know your brand better. You know it within the context of the business and the market you're in. And of course, market's always changing as well, so it's not bad that you review it. From that, I then do, if you want to, innovation, which then takes you inside the box innovation, not outside the box, which is quite a, you know, kind of a change in attitude. You don't want to be sitting with blue sky thinking, you want to start thinking inside the box and use what you've already got. So that's kind of, I do both ends, if you like. So the thinking side is very much enabling you to reinterrogate. It may come out the same answer, but it probably won't, and it's often you don't find the time to think about it. But then what's lovely is it then gives the arty farty lot, I call it. The arty farty lot then have a better, more informed brief. They're often past the process as well. And similar then through to PR, there's an understanding throughout the whole project rather than being pieces. So that's kind of...
So I want to bring it back to Simon. We do a little seasonal song. That'll work.
Yeah.
So when people come to you and they want services, how do you actually do an integration of all the services together?
You sit down with the client and you go through all the skill sets that you have and determine which one for you to have to do the project. It very rarely is overlap, but it could be over the lifetime of a piece of work. But that initial bit will be very lucky with the agility side of it, because we need to get the foundations right for agility. And then it's a question of determining which cherry picking. It's almost picking its creative, which are the expertise that you need to have into your project.
Quite often a layering process, and then obviously when you come to you, they already know their brand identity, their brand strategy, and they want a new campaign, and I guess that's at that point where they can come to you for some graphics and some design, and then maybe for yourself, Susan, they can have a fresh eye on how to deliver that campaign. So over the last few what campaigns have you been working on today, and what is on your to for the future?
Well, before I answer that, I would have to say that an awful lot of the time, the clients come to us thinking they know what they want, and when we get to the school of it, they don't, and they need to give them a bit of talks to us. And that's how to manage, but I've got a very good project for us, disempowered, but a lot of the time, you certainly find that that's packaging projects actually requires PR, and it requires a brand. And these projects come from different sources. I think probably the best example of a large collaboration is with Melty, where the product design team were designing the product.
Melty
was a sterilizer company, producer sterilizer. The babies in the hospital, and they have been around so long that people almost describe them as the sterilizers and what have you. It's about the babies, if you like. But the product design team came and suggested to the client, we know who can help you with the branding and the packaging. We said, well, we know who can help you with the website, and so on and so forth. It's like, it's organic how it grows.
And for yourself, which campaign have you personally enjoyed working on the most?
The ones with the clients in the
So don't keep going
with
this question.
But usually the ones that are creative, but the best part of it is the same to say that, but you can't get clients to go here about the months of the time. I can't think of one that I particularly stand out. Every month is a different project that I enjoy. Some are purely for the creative planning. Some are because it's just a great thing to be yourself with me. Some of it is a fantastic change, a great transformation that I can manage to be real. So all kinds of things as well. I can't choose one.
Too many good ones. I'm going to ask Susan, obviously you want to know what kind of things people have worked on, so for you Susan, what do you think about the juice and the most passion in a project that you've worked on?
It was the anniversary of the Battle of Britain, and it was a campaign where it was literally getting a journalist to fly in a Spitfire. Sounds kind of like a massive thing in a way, but actually to get him to do that was quite a big sell. On the back of that, we had a complete absolute adapting of products to the point that we are promoting. And then on the back of that, we've got a dogfish bed in a major national newspaper. So although it's quite a small campaign, it was absolutely targeted to perfection and it worked fantastically. It's been very satisfying. You know, what we do is all about reaching the audience. It's probably a really big audience, it's probably a really small audience, but I think what we will do is work hard to understand what that audience wants. And then like Simon said, what we do is cherry pick people who can make that personal life in whatever way. So it's kind of being clients being a kind of scope and creating the best possible campaign is like this.
Musical chairs, we get Jillian back over here. So Baz, in your photography career, what has been your most enjoyable assignment that you've done?
I suppose when I got to the PwC, I was just like, oh, so now I have to go through this week, so about 10 days ago. That was quite
a nice budget.
Nice budget, yeah, for the rest of it. And obviously, I've always wanted to come
collaboration and agencies working together to the next level.
And I haven't seen anybody else doing this or trying to do this in quite the same way as well. So, I really hope that it works. That's the truth.
So what do you think the margin is of having the structure that you have over and above this sort of normal company with employees?
Well, two things. One, in terms of company with employees, is you can imagine a client that happens so often. They require 5% of what that company offers, but they're paying for 100%. That's a simple accounting overhead that they can do that. In terms of us as a business, I see us expanding our areas of expertise. We haven't covered it all yet. Phone's a really good example. I may be able to see how I can connect and if you see what he's produced. He may have
nice things to do.
Yes. It may not be. But you can see it's completely organic and going like this.
And so you mentioned earlier that you want to have one, two, photography with one brand strategy, PR. Is there a potential to bring others into the fold?
Absolutely. The challenge would be, I suppose, if you put too many people on. This isn't about creating some kind of catalogue of agencies. The only people on there are the experts that we know and trust. And I don't want to particularly bring people that overlap the expertise that we have. So if you mention the photography repairs in Holland, the type of photography that we do is very different. So it's easy to identify who should be doing what. Sure, quite capable of helping out each do, but not as the experts. I see a little point in the whole of writing another product as a team. Who are going to do the same as the product design guys that you've got already. It's just, that's a relative distraction. That's not what we're looking
at. So we're going to open it up now to the audience. Does anybody have a question towards the panel? Is anyone brave enough to ask a question? I don't know whether there's anything. Maybe you supplied all the information that we needed for tonight. So, what we're going to do to wrap up is, Baz is a photographer, Susan does PR, Jill does brand strategy, and Simon does the graphical design element to it. That is just a small cross-section of what Chemistry Works does. There is also social media, branding, marketing, and more. So do check out the website. The website's now launched, which is the chemistryworks.co.uk. So do go check it out. It went live, I think, today. So do go and check it out. I've been Sarah Pemberton. I'm Synergie16 Business Wednesdays. We go on every Wednesday night in Jewry in Aldgate. We came back for a special night here at Hyde. So do please let me know your details. If I haven't got them already, so you can come down and check out our night. We always do a half-hour chat show, so you can get to know people behind the business that we're spotlighting. But finally, I'd like to have a big round of applause for the Chemistry Works. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Wow, what's up?